Hello guys, Barry here. Welcome back. In this video, we will continue making the zipline in Apex Legends. Let's get back to the zipline blueprint. It's ready in the force. Get correct zipline. If it's not equal to self, set the pathfinder with the overlapped character and set correct zipline to self. If false, hide the white edge. If true, set it visible. Add a gate node to event tick, then connect the progress event to the open. Valid get pathfinder. Get the pathfinder's location. Find a location close to the world location on spline. Minus the location with the location offset. Set it as the world location of scenes. Check the teleport. The next may be a little complicated. Let me say it slower. First, get the location of a point in front of the camera. Find the location of the point close to it on the spline and set it to the location of the white edge. Use find look at rotation to make sure the white edge is facing the player. As mentioned earlier, Apex zipline is bidirectional and can be written anywhere, so we need to calculate the player's direction. The dot product function can be used to determine if the direction is the same. So we can select which location is the target location by it. And then setter can read to truth. On component under overlap of spline mesh, cast to the BP pathfinder and get a correct zipline. If not equal to self, connect to close. If false, hide the white edge, then back to truth. Set conRed to false, hide the white edge, call the getting of event. Set the correct in zipline to none and pathfinder to none. Let's have a look at getting of. Stop audio. While it gets pathfinder, set the gravity scale to 1 and get its controller. Set ignore move input and detach it from the root component of pathfinder. Stop correct animation montage. Set the reading to false, target location to 0000. Next, give the character a forward and upward force. I found a bug. And let me fix it. It shall be working now. Now it's time for the writing event. Enable the move input and stop movement immediately. Set writing to true and hide the wattage. Set gravity scale to 0. Then we need to move and attach the character to the sense component. We should play a sound effect here. And then drive the character movement through the movement of sense component. And we will use the spline lines. Divide moving speed to calculate the moving time. When completed, call getting of event. Oh, and don't forget to stop writing, connect to stop. Let's try the spacebar. Okay, that's all about zipline in Apex Legends. There will be tutorials on Pathfinder's zipline gun later. Don't forget to subscribe and like. See you in the next video.